a film about philosophy and just in general what reality is. It was quite unexpected. I honestly started it for fun and I just didn't know it would make it to the film, you know? And if you just look at the black hole texture and its gravitational lensing effect, which is quite accurate, it's all procedural, meaning it's not an image. It's not, the texture is all generated by these mathematical equations. It's crazy, like just the sheer amount of dust particles in it. It's just insane.
Were the difficulties while filming the movie Debugging Reality?
Well, honestly, it was hard to do the motion acting because acting in front of green screen is kind of hard because, I mean, you cannot really contradict with the motions that are happening in the green screen. So it's kind of, you know, it's kind of awkward to do, honestly, the motion acting.
And when I was younger, I was obsessed with Harry Potter, and one of the things that I really liked about the movie Harry Potter is the soundtracks. John Williams really knew how to convey just about everything that film just needed from the soundtrack to the audience in a very, very effective way. And definitely he has been one of my mentors when it comes to music production. And, you know, just the film itself was also really amazing. A lot of my inspirations came from, you know, the 7 series of, you know, the Harry Potter's film series.
Hey guys, welcome to my studio, and today we're just gonna have a look at this soundtrack I'm working on. So, if you just go all the way back there, back to the beginning of the whole song, it starts with this, you know, little piano thing. Bum 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 bum. So I first got this idea when I, you know, when I was just kind of messing with the keyboard, I guess. The basic chord progression is actually just very simple. It's just like, you know, just a question and a reply. A question would be, you know, and a reply to that question would be a little bit like, so this is like another reply to that previous question. So yeah, you guys do know that I follow Hans Zimmer a lot, and I watched his masterclass as well. And I,
you know, another thing that Einstein's theory of relativity predicted was black holes.
When someone asks what would happen if a human fell on a black hole, most would probably expect to die instantly. But the reality is way stranger than that. If you were to come too close to a black hole, you would get spaghettified. Sir Martin Rees coined the term spaghettification, which is a perfectly good way to put it. You'd eventually become a stream of subatomic particles that swirl into the black hole.
Okay, so now, it turns out on a black hole, the escape velocity is so high that you have to, speed of light is not good enough. So if light doesn't come out, nothing's coming out.
So you mentioned about the green screen. It must have been really difficult to visualize a black hole in your head, as if you're falling into this, you know, massive celestial object.
Well, it was hard to do the falling in front of the green screen. So, it was really rough. Cause I mean, like, cause doing the acting of like this and pretending to look like falling down, it was honestly kind of hard. But I liked the idea cause it was creative, and I think I knew that it would be a perfect fit in the movie, and it would be a great scene.
Do you think we're living in the AI?
I'm not sure about that. And if we are, then that means we have a second chance, right?
What kind of second chance are you talking about?
Well, if like in the Matrix, if we are like plugged into machines, and if we get freed, then yeah, then that means we have another chance in the real world.
Like, are you talking like worlds stacked onto another world,
And then if you, like a parallel universe.
Yeah, that kind of thing.
Oh, I see. So it's like Doctor Strange, when you change something, the timeline kind of forks into two, right?
Yeah.
What would you do if you kind of wake up in the middle of nowhere, where robots are dominating the world, and then humans are sort of like they're humans are basically like a food for a robot to kind of feed in, you know, kind of get fed. I don't know how to describe it. Like,
yeah, I'd probably do what Neo did. I'll probably try to hide and find some place where it's safe, I guess.
Would you be willing to like face the reality, or like you know, like in Matrix, the agent gives Neo two choices, or other characters who kind of rebelled against the robots two choices: whether you stay in their Matrix, forget everything, but live happily after, like live rich and get everything, you know, materialistic desires, everything.
Well,
or would you rather just face truth and then, you know, make a rebellion group or something against the robots?
Well, I wouldn't want to face the truth. I mean, I'm not asking to be rich in the Matrix, but like, I would just stay in the Matrix, like as I am right now. Well, I don't have to be rich to stay in the Matrix. I can just stay.
You would rather forget everything?
Yeah, I wouldn't want to face the truth.
Oh, you don't want to face the truth?
Yeah, well, I'm not bothering to.
Are you scared?
Well, not like being scared. I think because I want to do so much stuff in this world right now. And,
right. All right, thank you for the interview. Do a little bit of a close-up, like, punch. Like...
No, wait, he doesn't...
Yeah, obviously, something. I'm kidding.